Come and listen to my story about a man named Jed. A poor mountaineer barely kept his family fed. And then one day he was shooting at some food, and up through the ground come a bubbling crude. Oil, that is, black gold, Texas tea. Well, the first thing you know, old Jed's a millionaire. The kinfolk said, Jed, move away from there. Said, California is the place you ought to be. So they loaded up the truck and they moved to Beverly Hills, that is, swimming pools, movie stars.
The Beverly Hillbillies.
Still asleep?
I listened at her door. Not a peep.
Buggy stashed out front. Come on.
Jed, before we paint them buggy wheels, can we have some breakfast?
Well, it ain't gonna be time, boy. Granny'll be up in a minute. It's after four now. Billy, you keep watch. Let us know the minute you hear Granny stirring.
Yes, sir, Pop.
Come on, boy. You got a paint outside?
Yes, sir. But ain't you afraid all that growling and grumbling will wake Granny?
What growling and grumbling?
My stomach. I ain't had nothing to eat since the midnight snack.
Get your stomach for a little while. It's gonna be worth it to see Granny's face when she finds his buggy out here this morning.
I reckon so, but how come it's got to have yellow wheels?
Well, something Granny's been wanting all her life. Nice, shiny, black buggy with yellow wheels. Now that Mr. Drysdale has bought her this fine, high-stepping horse, we is going to surprise her with the rest of the rig. I'll get the other side.
Yes, sir.
What in the blue blazes?
Morning, Jed. Wondering what happened to all the lanterns.
What's a big idea?
I was afraid you'd forget about the yeller wheels.
How long you knowed about this buggy?
Since you fetched it home last evening.
We was gonna spring it on you.
I know. I figured I'd be done painting and be back up in bed in time for you to surprise me. I couldn't find a lantern.
Jed, if you and Granny don't quit talking so loud, you're gonna wake Granny.
Granny?
She knows all about it.
Hot dog. Now we can eat.
Now, hold on, boy. By the time Granny's through making breakfast, we can be done painting these wheels.
Yeah. Then you can surprise me.
I sure wonder how she found out this buggy was here.
Search me. I done everything I could to keep it a secret.
You did?
Yes, sir. I told her last night. I says, don't open that front door, because there's something out there you ain't supposed to see.
Good work, boy. Thank you.
How'd you get downstairs without me seeing you?
Never mind, Ellie. Come help me get breakfast.
But wait, Granny. You was gonna get a surprise.
I know all about it, honey.
But Granny!
There's a horse sleeping in the parlor here.
Yes, sir, Granny. That was a surprise I didn't want you to get.
What you doing in here?
Well, you said you couldn't sleep in my room no more. Lady Ben likes it here just fine.
Milburn, I'm warning you. If the Clampets keep that horse on the premises another day...
Don't worry, Margaret. She goes back this morning.
What I can't understand is why you bought it for them in the first place.
As an investment. Lady Bell is a champion bred harness racer. I didn't know they were going to make a house pet out of it.
House pet?
I understand Ellie May let it sleep in her room.
Well... For once, that mansion had a well-bred occupant. Now, remember, this morning...
Don't worry. This is one time I'm with you. That's a $30,000 racehorse.
That's it, Lady Bell. Step high and handsome. Show your style. That's it. Whoa!
Granny.
Morning, Mr. Drysdale. How do you like my buggy?
Well, fine, but you shouldn't let Lady Bell pull it.
Why not?
Granny, I want to take her back where I bought her.
Well, she ain't that bad. All I have to do is break her from wanting to trot all the time.
Well, look, Granny, I'm a little late getting down to the bank, so...
Get in. I'll get you there in a jiffy.
Well, no.
I can get her to gallop if I need to. You see me win the race.
Well, it's not that. I have a ride to the bank.
Well, then I'll take Miss Drysdale for a spin.
No, please.
Why not?
Because I've changed my mind. I'd like you to drive me to the bank.
Fine. But I want your wife to see my new rig. I'll call her. Miss Drysdale!
You don't want Margaret to see this?
Oh. Afraid she'll want one, huh?
Yeah. That's it. Let's go. I'm late.
Oh, hear that, Lady Bell? Just like Ellie showed you for the race. Cut loose! This beats riding in that limousine, don't it? Come on, Lady Bell, show him some real speed.
Pop, Granny's coming.
Well, it's about time. I was getting worried.
Oh, Lady Bell, easy, girl. Cool her down, young'uns. She's been clean to town and back.
So that's where you been.
Took Mr. Drysdale to work.
How do you like the buggy ride?
Jed, he plumb loved it. When we pulled up in front of the bank, he didn't want to get out.
He didn't, huh?
Had to pry his hands loose. He was hanging on so hard that his knuckles turned white. And he was kind of trembling and breathing heavy.
Sounds like he enjoyed it, all right. Maybe he'll be getting a buggy.
I sure hope so. Jed, I was thinking of it all the way home. How nice it would be for Miss Drysdale. She could take her husband to work, go shopping. Every once in a while, we'd meet up, me and my buggy and her and her, and maybe have a little friendly race.
Like you used to have with Elverina Bradshaw back home.
Yeah. Jed, why don't we give the Drysdales a horse and buggy as a present?
My doggie, Granny, that's a real neighborly thought.
Ain't it, though? Friendly, kind, generous. And it's the only way I can make sure that she don't get a faster rig than mine.
How did the tranquilizers take an effect yet?
I'm feeling better now. Help me to my desk.
Go, you're not in the buggy, Bill.
Listen, you can retrieve Lady Bell. Granny's bought another horse.
She's bought another horse?
Yes, the stable just called to check her credit.
Oh, this is wonderful. Well, let's hurry up there and grab Lady Bell. I can get my $30,000 back.
Excuse me, Chief, but how are you going to get Lady Bell back to Hollywood Park?
I'll carry her in my arm.
Drysdale's a horse and buggy?
Sure did, Jed. It's a dandy rig. Miss Drysdale and me's gonna have some first-class races.
Well, good. Let's go have a look. Hi, doggy. That is a fast-looking buggy.
Best I could find.
Now, from a look at this horse, you and Miss Drysdale is gonna be about an even match. She is the twin of Lady Bell.
Well, this is Lady Bell, Paul.
Where's Miss Drysdale's horse?
Jethro's walking her around side the house.
Yeah, she's a high-spirited animal, Jed. Her name's Lightning. Let's go eat.
Well, I want to see her, Jethro!
When you've seen one horse, you've seen them all. Come on, now, I'm hungry.
Go ahead and eat. I want to take a look at Lightning.
Yoni, she comes.
If you go to life, I'm going to have to take you around back.
Who named his horse Lightning?
I did.
Granny, was you honestly fixing to give this poor old animal to Miss Drysdale?
What do you mean, poor old animal? All it needs is a little grooming and some good food.
Well, it used to chew with.
It's got teeth. Hasn't a it, Jethro?
Yes, ma'am. One upper, one lower.
Nobody asked you to count.
Now, Granny, you do the right thing and take this horse back where you bought it.
Well, I don't think they'll take it back. It was on sale.
Yeah, $175.
For this critter?
No, sir, for the buggy. They threw the horse in free.
Well, you take it back and get Miss Drysdale an animal she can be proud of.
She can be proud of this one.
Yeah, the fella said it's the world's oldest living horse.
Granny, you know good and well Miss Drysdale wouldn't have a chance of winning the race with this animal. You want to beat her fair and square, don't you?
Not especially. No.
Take it back, Jethro.
Do I have to? I had a dickens of a time lifting it up on the truck.
You mean it rode over here on the truck?
Yeah, set up on the back and fell sound asleep.
Well, you can have another snooze on the way back. Granny, I am plumb ashamed of you.
Doggone it, Jed. Back home, Elverna Bradshaw beat me every Sunday for 30 years. I'm an old woman, Jed. And before I go to my reward, I'd like to win one buggy race.
You're missing the most important part. It ain't that you win or lose, but how you play the game.
That's all right for him. But at my age, I gotta take my wins any way I can get them. Well, Lightning, you pert near got in a race.
Oh, no. Look what they've done to Lady Bell.
Chief, that can't be Lady Bell.
You weren't on that buggy ride. It aged me 20 years, and I didn't run.
That must be the horse Granny got to replace Lady Bell.
Oh.
Granny, what a magnificent animal.
Where? Oh, you mean old Gloopa, Lightning. You like her, huh?
Oh, she's beautiful. She's a much better horse than Lady Bell.
You know something, Mr. Drysdale? For a city fella, you sure are a shrewd judge of horseflesh.
Well, doesn't take an expert to see that she's a real champion.
Drysdale, I'll tell you what I'm gonna do.
What?
I'm gonna give you that champion horse.
Well, what for?
Well, that buggy. I'm gonna throw that in, too.
But I have no use for a horse and buggy.
Well, it's really for your missus.
Margaret?
You said she wanted one.
I did? Yes, I guess I did.
Well, now she's got one. And her and me can have some nice buggy races.
Buggy races?
Well, kind of friendly affairs around the neighborhood.
But Margaret hasn't had any experience.
That's all right. Lightning has had enough experience for the both of them.
Well, thank you, but I don't...
Are you turning down my gift?
Oh, no. Of course not.
Good. Then wake her up. I mean, hitch her up. Well, take her home.
I don't know how to hitch up a horse.
I'll show you.
No, you show Miss Hathaway. I have something to discuss with Mr. Clampett.
Mr. Drysdale, this buggy racing is something Granny's had in her craw for 30 years now, and ain't none of us gonna get no peace or quiet around here till she's shed of it.
But my wife...
Now, if Granny could just womp your wife in one race, I figure she'd be satisfied and forget all about it.
But I don't...
Your wife wouldn't mind doing that, would she? For me?
Mr. Clampett, she'd be delighted.
Me? Race with Granny in a buggy in public? You must be demented.
Margaret, sweetheart, listen. Please do this for me. I'm begging you.
Milburn, for 4 years, I've been begging you to rid our neighborhood of those squatters. Have you ever listened to me?
Of course.
But you've never lifted a finger to get rid of them.
No, but I've listened to you. Margaret, wait, please.
Milburn, just how much does this mean to you?
Everything, anything. Name your price. A dinner out, a new girdle. All right. You name it.
Very well. This is my price. I will race with Granny if you will get the Clampets out of Beverly Hills permanently.
You know I can't do that.
Goodbye.
Mr. Drysdale!
Mr.
Here's your horse and buggy.
Well, where's the horse?
Oh, she give out on the way. Ellie and Miss Jane are fetching her.
Margaret, Margaret, come back. I'll meet your price.
You will?
Yes. If you race with Granny and beat her, I'll see that the Krampus move.
Wonderful. Beat her?
Well, that's a foregone conclusion. You'll be driving a horse by the name of Lightning. It can go as fast as Jane Hathaway's convertible.
You're joking.
My word of honor. She was driving, and that horse stayed right behind her. That's my girl. I'll go tell Granny the good news.
Have them start packing.
I'll do that. Hurry. Get this magnificent thoroughbred out of sight until race time.
Well, Jethro, you lifted her in. Now, lift her out.
Yes, ma'am. Well, Granny, Mr. Drysdale says the race is on.
Your wife agreed, did she?
Yes, Margaret accepted the challenge.
I'm gonna beat the pants off her. I mean, we'll have a dandy race.
Did you get Miss Drysdale a good horse?
Mr. Drysdale says she's better than Lady Bell, didn't you?
Absolutely. Margaret couldn't have a more perfect horse for the race.
I'm proud of you.
Well, it's, like you said, it's how you play the game.
Well, come on, Mr. Drysdale, let's go take a look at her.
Oh, Jed, I almost forgot. I mixed up a special feed for Lady Bell. Some bran and oats and alfalfa and molasses. But I left it in the kitchen. Would you get it for me?
You bet I will. Excuse me, Mr. Drysdale.
Boss.
I wouldn't let Jed see Lightning if I were you. He sets a great store on having the horses even matched.
I understand.
He's seen that Lightning was a better horse than Lady Bell. He might call the race off.
Don't worry. Now,
Granny says she mixed up some special feed.
Yeah. Gee, I wish I'd have known you wanted it. I'd have saved you some.
You mean you ate it?
Yes, sir.
All of it?
Just this one potful.
Oh, you take the cake.
Where?
Never mind.
But, Uncle Jed, I'm still hungry. Lifting that horse in and out of Miss Jane's car give me an appetite.
You put a horse in Miss Jane's car?
Yes, sir. That was the only way we could get that poor old thing over to the Drysdales.
Poor old thing.
Lightning. Here, Uncle Jed. I scraped you up a spoonful.
Oh, thanks. So Granny stuck Miss Drysdale with Lightning, huh?
They call her Old Glue Pot over to the stable.
Well, she ain't gonna get away with it. You and me is going over to that stable and get Miss Drysdale the finest buggy horse money can buy.
Okay. Sure you don't want some of this?
No, thanks. Come on. I just changed my mind.
Too late. I swallowed it.
I got a better idea about the horse. We are really gonna learn Granny to cheat.
No need to do that. She does pretty good right now.
Milburn, I'm going out for a while.
Okay, dear. When will you... What kind of a get-up is that?
It's a riding habit. I'm going for a trial run of my horse and buggy.
Oh, don't do that, Margaret. You want Lightning fresh for the big race.
And speaking of the race, let us reconfirm our agreement.
I'll put it in writing for you. If you beat Granny, the Krampus will move away.
For good.
For good. So, now, why don't you let that poor old... let Lightning rest until race time. Besides, you don't even know how to hitch her up.
Mr. Krampus has done that for me. And now he's going to give me a driving lesson.
My pleasure, ma'am. I just want to see you had a fair chance of winning.
Hey, this horse looks like Lady Bell.
There's a resemblance, ain't it? Oh, you just sit up here beside me for a spell, and later on, you can take the reins.
Mr. Clampett, you don't know what you're doing.
Oh, I think I do. Once you've drove a buggy, you don't forget. Let's go, Lightning.
What a goof-up. I wonder how I can blame this on Miss Hathaway.
Another batch of my special fish. see, Lady Bell, this'll give you that extra go power. Not that you need it to beat that old plug of a lightning. Now, Lady Bell, you don't have to hang your head. If anybody says the race ain't fair, I'll take the blame. Come on now, stand up straight. Boat blacking. You ain't Lady Bell. You's lightning. Somebody's trying to fix the race. Miss Drysdale. If there's one thing I can't stand, it's a cheater.
Hey, Brittany, race time, where are you?
Well, she ain't upstairs, Pop.
She sure ain't downstairs.
She ain't outside, Uncle Jed. I looked every place.
Well, youngins, I reckon there's nothing left for us to do but go out front and tell everybody that Granny has turned chicken. That she has got a yellow streak up her back, and she is just plumb scared to death to race Ms. Drysdale.
Just a doggone minute. I ain't chicken, and I ain't got no yellow streak, and I ain't scared.
Then what was you doing in the broom closet?
I stepped in there by mistake. And hush up.
Granny, everybody's waiting out front for the race to commence.
The buggies is out there and all hitched up.
Well, you two youngins get out there and tell them I'm coming. And tell them I can beat Miss Drysdale driving a hay wagon hitched to a hog.
That-a-way, Granny.
What are you going back in there for?
Well, she ain't driving no hay wagon hitched to a hog, and I ain't got a chance.
You are going out there and take your lumps.
I'll be the laughing stock of Beverly Hills with that glue pot.
That's what you was planning for Miss Drysdale, wasn't it? Come on.
No. I'm an old woman, Jed. I don't think I can make it. My ticker ain't so good.
A mule should have your ticker. Come on.
No. Wait. Let me get a bottle of tonic in case my liver goes sour. I'm awful old, Jed.
Yeah, let's go. Here she is, folks. The race can commence. Granny?
I'm coming. I just wanted to get a little straw for my horse.
Good luck, Granny.
Good luck, Gran.
I remember what I told you. It ain't that you win or lose. It's how you play the game.
Yeah, I'll remember. Here, old lady, I know your teeth ain't much. Take a good, stiff pull on this straw. How does that grab you? Wait till I get on first.
On your mark. Get set.
And I see Granny, but look!
Oh, my dear little girl! I win!
Where's your buggy?
Lightning runs so fast, she pulled right out of the harness.
Where's my wife?
Running a poor second. And I hope this teaches her a lesson. Cheating don't pay.
Time to say goodbye to Jed and all his kin. They would like to thank you folks for kindly dropping in. You're all invited back next week to this locality to have a heaping helping of their hospitality. Hillbilly, that is. Set a spell. Take your shoes off. Y'all come back now. Here.
This has been a Filmways presentation.